Hello friends, welcome to Wikipedia. We have started series on disputed islands. We have already covered around 4 to 5 disputed islands. Just to recap, what is disputed island? It means that those islands or those portions of the land which are under dispute due to its possession or which is claimed by more than two countries. What may be the reason of claim or what may be the reason of dispute? The reason of dispute may be its mineral resources, rivers, cultural or religious region. And what this dispute can lead to? It can lead to war, terrorism, or rise of non-state entities. Carrying forward this series, we have come out with another disputed island, which is known as Dokdo, or Liancourt Rocks, or Tekshima. And the countries which are involved in these two islands or in this island are Japan and South Korea. Means this is dispute between Japan and South Korea. If you look at the location of this disputed island, it is exactly in the midway between Japan and South Korea. It is equidistant from these two countries. And this island is surrounded by around 30 steep cliff rocks. Why is it called Liancourt, Dokdo, or Tekshima? Japanese call it Tekshima. Koreans call it Dokdo, and other nations call it Liancourt. Liancourt something refers to French name. It was discovered in 15th century by French people. In 1849, French ships went around this island and named as Liancourt Rocks, as it is surrounded by 30 steep cliff rocks. Koreans call it Dokdo, which means solitary islands. Japanese call it Tekshima, which means bamboo islands. Means Japanese by Tekshima by Japanese, Liancourt by other nations. French name Dokdo, South Korea. Even if you look at the official papers, according to Japanese, on their official website, Japanese call it, this island is part of Sea of Japan. Look at the water. This is Sea of Japan. Koreans call it as East Asia, water of East Asia. Means these two countries named that portion of the land in different ways and in different waters. Sea of Japan. And East Asia. If you look at the geography, surrounded by steep rocks, equidistant from both Japan and South Korea. And if you look at the history of this island, history goes back to around 15th century. If we start from 15th century, we can easily trace the history of this island. In 1696, it was believed that this island was recognized by Japan as Korean territory. In 1905, it was occupied by Japan. After the end of Second World War, it was returned to Korea. Means its history can be traced in three phases. From 1696 till 1905, it was under possession of Korea. From 1905 till Second World War, it was under possession of Japan. After Second World War till today, it is under South Korea. एंट, इकोनॉमिक इंपॉर्टेंस एज ऑल आइलैंड्स हैव गॉट इकोनॉमिक इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ मैरीन लाइफ, फिशरी एंड ऑयल रिसोर्सेज. इफ यू लुक एट एनी आइलैंड ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, यू कैन इजली रिकॉग्नाइज दैट दे हैव गॉट लॉट ऑफ मैरीन रिसोर्सेज, फिशरी एंड ऑयल रिसोर्सेज. इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द वैल्यू विच दे आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम दीज आइलैंड्स, विच दे आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम दीज मैरीन लाइफ, दीज आइलैंड्स आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम दीज मैरीन लाइफ. बट दिस इज ऑस्टेंसिबल रीजन, मीन्स बोथ साउथ कोरिया एंड जापान क्लेम इट फॉर देयर फिशरी एंड ऑयल रिसोर्सेज, बट दिस इज नॉट द रियल रीजन. रियल रीजन इज समथिंग डिफरेंट. व्हाट्स द रियल रीजन? दिस इज प्रेस्टीज इशू फॉर बोथ कंट्रीज. नॉर्थ कोरियंस एंड साउथ कोरियंस, दे बोथ आर कल्चर लिविंग पीपल. दे डो नॉट वॉन्ट एनी मॉडिफिकेशन इन देयर कल्चर. दे डोंट वॉन्ट टू लीव वॉट दे हैव गॉट. दे डो नॉट वॉन्ट टू चेंज वॉट दे हैव इनहेरिटेड फ्रॉम देयर फोर फादर्स. कोरियंस बिलीव दैट दिस आइलैंड वॉज पार्ट ऑफ कोरियन कल्चर फ्रॉम 14th century टिल टूडे, एंड दे डोंट want it to be shared with any other country. They just want to keep it. This is their prestige issue. Thousands, even I can say lakhs of Koreans visit this island yearly, annually, on boats, ships, have food there, take selfies, simply raise their flags and come back to South Korea. This is their prestige issue. This is their pilgrimage site also. They simply do not want to leave it. And this is criticized by Japan. Japan every year criticized that South Koreans should not come to this island and flag there or station their flags there. And if you look at the population of this island, only two fishermen, husband and wife, stay here. And there are around 50 government personnel living here. What South Korea has done, South Korea has stationed around 50 government officials on this island to just mark their presence or claim. What has happened recently which led to tension between these two countries? What has been done? It is believed that one South Korean man, why it is believed, because this is not proven fact. One South Korean man, he has rammed his van in Japanese embassy in Seoul. And it led to a sort of crisis between Japan and South Korea. Japan criticized the ramming of van by one South Korean in its embassy. What we can conclude that both countries are trying to sort this issue on table, but as it has become prestige issue for both of these countries, it seems that this is not going to be solved by sitting on the table. There is need of some other solution for sorting out this problem. It has become prestige issue for both these countries. No solution is visible in the coming days. Thanks. Share this video.